Greetings, EBC Greenhouse family. This is Minister Eric coming to you once again. Family, I want you to do me a big favor. I want you to think about this for a second. Have you ever met any of your friends' parents and thought to yourself, man, he looks just like his dad? Or thought to yourself, wow, she looks just like her mom. I tell you, it's amazing sometimes how similar children can be to their parents. But I'm not just talking about physical appearance. I'm talking about in the things they say and in their actions as well. Speaking of being similar, did you know that as children of God, as Christians, we are supposed to be like him? That's right. The same way little children are trying to imitate their natural parents, we as Christians should be trying to imitate God as well. Now, I'm not saying you run out here today and you try to create your own little world. No, I'm not talking about that. I'm not saying you run out here trying to create the sun, the moon, the stars, the cows, the goats, the insects, all that. No, that would certainly be silly. But what I am saying, what I am talking about, what I am suggesting is we should be trying to imitate the character of God. That's what I'm talking about. We should be trying as Christians to imitate the character of God, because God is perfect and there's nothing about God that we should not want to copy. In fact, in the book of Matthew, chapter 5, verse 48, Jesus tells us to be perfect, even as your Father, which is in heaven, is perfect. But you ask, how in the world, Minister Eric, am I ever going to be perfect? How in the world am I going to do that? Glad you ask. The only way we're going to ever be perfect is in and through Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ is the eternal Son of God. He is exactly like God the Father. But he took a human nature and became a man. In fact, in the book of Colossians, it states, Christ is the visible image of the invisible God. We read about the life of Jesus in the book of Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. By learning what Jesus is like from these Bible books and following his example, we actually find out how to imitate the character of God. We discover traits like being kind. Kind! That's right, being kind, patient, loving, humble, compassionate, self-control. Self-control, you ask? That's right. We learn these character traits about God through the life of Jesus in these Bible books. I tell you this, although Jesus Christ demonstrated many, I mean many, worthy qualities of God the Father, I tell you, his greatest example of demonstrating the character of God the Father is in his self-sacrifice and the holiness. We are sinners. That's right. You and I, we're straight sinners. We deserve death because we have broken God's laws. And I'm sad to say that I've broken many of them. But praise be to God, because he gave us Jesus. And Jesus came and lived in this earth without sinning at all. He never sinned. And Jesus chose to die in our place. That's love. Jesus showed his love towards us by sacrificing himself so that we could live. If we repent of our sin and trust in his death and his resurrection, he forgives us and saves us, and God adopts us into his family. We become children of God. After that, we are supposed to follow the example of Jesus, of living a life of love, self-sacrifice, and holiness. Being perfect I tell you, we talked about this perfect earlier. The only way we're going to do it is in it through Jesus Christ. That's what God is talking about in Ephesians chapter 5, verses 1 through 4. He tells us to imitate God. As you read these verses in Ephesians chapter 5, verse 1 through 4, I want you to take note of what God is saying about imitating Him and how that will impact our lives. After you read them, I want you to study these verses. Studying gets a little bit more in depth, gets a little bit beyond the surface of just reading. And when you finish studying these verses, I want you to answer these three questions. Question number one, how do you now feel knowing that you are a dear child of God? Question number two, how should you walk? What I mean by that is, now that you have read these four verses, what characteristic should be displayed in your life? What should your life be full of? That's what I'm saying. And question number three, what are some actions as dear children of God that we should not be displaying in our life? That's the last question. Family, stay well, be safe, God bless, take care.